Okay, good afternoon to everyone and welcome to the coordinator's workshop for the workshop on pedagogy for effective use of ICT in engineering education. So as all of you may know, the main workshop is in January 2015 and today is the coordinator's workshop. So let's start by talking a little bit about why this workshop, and especially because most of the workshops that you may be used to are about a certain domain, some topics such as thermodynamics or computer programming. So why this particular workshop, and what does this long title of pedagogy for use of ICT mean, and so on. So the scenario we have today is that technology, especially information and communication technologies, are there everywhere, and they're also being used a lot in education. Computers, internet, mobiles, lots of applications, MOOCs, Google Docs, so many others. Everybody encourages its use. The government is really behind all of us to use ICT more and also more effectively. Some of you may have used learning management systems. Many of you might be familiar with a new format of course called Massive Open Online Course, or MOOC, which anybody can take. These courses are being offered from Stanford and MIT and several places in the world. IIT Bombay has also offered a few MOOCs. And other technologies like animations and wiki are something that you may be familiar with or may even have used in your own classes. So the main point is that technology, ICT, is there in education everywhere today. And the reason they're there is because they have a lot of benefits, learning benefits and motivational benefits associated with them. But the potential of these technologies is lost or cannot be realized unless they're paired up with appropriately effective pedagogical strategies. So what I mean by this is, if you take something like an animation, what most people would do is demonstrate the animation in class. Now it turns out, and we'll go over this a lot in the workshop, that simply showing a video or showing an animation is actually not very effective, in the sense that the learners, our students, don't learn much by simply watching videos. Instead, they need to do some other active learning strategies in addition to the videos. So as teachers, you and I have to integrate these more active pedagogical strategies when we use technologies. So a large part of the course is about how do we pick appropriate pedagogical strategies, how do we integrate them while using ICT. And now the title might make more sense because it starts with the word pedagogy. So it's the appropriate pedagogy which makes the use of technology more effective for engineering college teachers. So as teachers, what we all need to have a knowledge of, other than domain, of course domain is what we start with, but we assume that everybody is aware of domain knowledge. So in addition to domain, teachers need to be aware of and have a good knowledge of which ICT tools are useful for various teaching and learning objectives. And it has to start with what is meant by a teaching learning objective, and that's a large part of this workshop. And once we know which tools are useful, once we select them, the next thing teachers need to be very intimately familiar with is how to use these tools effectively and what pedagogical strategies to use along with it. So the motivation of the workshop essentially is this integration of effective pedagogy with the use of information and communication technology, which is there everywhere. So what we have done here is highlighted this point of how to use them effectively, because that we are going to keep coming back to it. It's not just about the usage of technology tool, but it's mainly about how to use these tools effectively. Okay, so what are the specific goals of this workshop? What you will do, you and the participants will do in the workshop, is to begin by articulating, by defining very clear teaching learning objectives for your own courses, the courses that you will be teaching next semester. So one thing we want this workshop to do for everybody is help you create resources and design lesson plans for the courses that you're teaching, so that you can immediately go and implement what you're doing in what you learn in this workshop in your own courses, in your own classes that you're teaching. So start by articulating the objectives for your course, then explore ICT tools appropriate for some of these objectives. So we will pick some learning objectives. For example, let's say you want students to be able to understand some abstract concept like electromagnetic waves. That can be one learning objective. So which ICT tools are appropriate for helping students understand how electromagnetic waves or electromagnetic fields transform? Once you explore the ICT tools, then you have to pair it up with and integrate it with effective pedagogical strategies for teaching with these tools. And this is what we went over in the previous slide, if you recall. And finally, the goal of the entire workshop is at the end to equip you to use these above strategies so that you design materials and activities for your own course. So this is going to be a very important goal, and it's not a theoretical course, it's very hands-on, where you'll be writing, creating, designing activities and course materials. Okay, so a little bit about the logistics. This may look complicated, but I'll just walk you through the entire sessions. So this workshop is in multiple phases, and also the modes are different. We start off on January 5th, 2015, very early in the new year. And for 3 days, January 5th, 6th and 7th, the workshop will be held in synchronous remote classroom mode, where you will, what is synchronous remote classroom mode? Participants will assemble in their respective colleges, that is your colleges for which you are the coordinator. Sessions will be conducted from here, from IIT Bombay via AVU. And sessions will be in workshop mode. There'll be extensive interaction, two-way floor transfers, lots of activities. And in the centers, in your own centers, participants will work in groups and they will explore the tools, they'll do the activities, they'll design materials, they'll do peer review and so on. And every day there'll be several open question and answer sessions via AVU. So we call these as synchronous remote center component, because at a time there are about 200 such centers simultaneously, synchronously logging in, and they're all at remote locations, I mean at the remote centers, at the RCs, and we'll be, it's like there's one big class with 200 classrooms. The main theme in these, in this part of the workshop is learning the what, why, how of using the tools and strategies. So this, especially the first part of it, January 5th, 6th and 7th, is introduction to different ICT tools for different objectives and some pedagogical strategies. Then comes the online component from January 8th to 18th, and in the online component, participants will be creating materials, lots more materials and activities for their own courses. And they'll also be giving feedback to their peers, getting feedback, also getting feedback from our TAs. So this is from 8th to 18th, and we call it 1 week equivalent of work. So we will post materials, we will post resources such as videos, and there'll be homework assignments. Participants have to complete the assignments by the due date and submit them on Moodle. Throughout the workshop, we'll be using Moodle as the platform to post resources, post homework assignments, to submit assignments and so on. And there'll be chat sessions and feedback sessions available on Moodle itself. So going back to the dates, synchronous remote classroom from 5th, 6th, 7th, and then an online phase. And this workshop is a little different in the sense there is a second session of synchronous remote classroom mode and followed by a wrap-up online mode. So the reason these two have been split up is because this is not a lecture-based course. This workshop is not going to be useful if participants come and sit and listen to what we say, because during the first 3 days we will be doing some demonstrations, some examples, and participants will be creating some activities in the RCs. But this is a very important phase, the second online phase, where they have to, from their own colleges, they can work in the evenings and nights if they want to, but they have to create a lot of homework assignments and materials, and then they come back for the follow-up. So we'll be doing advanced strategies and advanced tools in the second part, for which doing the online homeworks in between is essential. And finally, January 22nd to 31st will be the wrap-up online phase, where the goal, the theme then would be to consolidate all common resources for the community. So what this means is that every participant in every RC would have created materials. And what we want to try to do then is people who are teaching a particular course. So let's say there's a group of people in across several RCs who are teaching computer programming. We want them to get to discuss their assignments with each other, and finally by the end of the workshop, we want a set of assignments and learning materials and curriculum materials for a few important courses, which we will identify as the workshop progresses. And there will be summary sessions during the final wrap-up online course. So what I want to, let me just go back to the dates, because there is something I want to mention here. Participants must attend all synchronous remote classroom sessions in both part 1 and part 3. It's not sufficient to attend only one of them. The workshop is not complete. And participants must do all the work assigned. So as RC coordinators, one of your important roles is to emphasize that this is actually, it's a 2-week equivalent workshop spread over all of January. Out of the 2 weeks, 1 week, which is 3 days plus 3 days, is in synchronous remote classroom where they'll physically assemble in the RCs, and 1 week equivalent happens online. So as soon as this session is over today, we'll post these slides, but the schedule is something which as RCs you have to emphasize, and participants might ask you, well, can I attend only the first part and not the second part? But that's not possible. So a certificate will be given only after they attend all these sessions and do all the assignments. Okay. So a little bit more about what happens before the workshop. So far I've been talking about what happens during the main part, but we want to get participants kickstarted into the workshop itself. So December 23rd onwards, we will open a wiki for this workshop. So wiki is essentially, if you haven't used it, a wiki is like a web page which can be collaboratively edited. Each one of you RC coordinators and each workshop coordinators and each participant can not only read the web page but can also contribute to it. So we'll start posting some materials on the wiki itself. We'll help you get a login, etc. And you will get familiar, the participants will get familiar with using the wiki, and they'll start reflecting on what's created, and we'll start providing guidelines on how to use the wiki. But essentially what all people have to do is log into the wiki from December 23rd onwards. And what we have been doing is participants and colleges, especially colleges which have been very active in the wiki part of it, we have special certificates for the college as a whole, that this remote center has been very active in the creation and usage of wikis. So that's something we've provided in the past. The collaboration angle, the collaborative component, is a very important component of this workshop. Okay. So what exactly happens in the wiki between December 23rd and January 5th, 10 days prior to the workshop? Participants will register, and we'll help create individual web pages for every participant, departmental web pages for electrical engineering and mechanical and computer science and so on, and institution or RC web pages. So that's the first part. In the online part, if you remember, January 8th to 18th was an online part. The work, a lot of the work will be on Moodle as well as on the wiki. And the reason we prefer wikis, and you'll also see that, is that there's no hassle of file uploads and all. It's very easy to interact with your peers. So when teachers interact with wikis, you can use the same format for your own students in your classes. So Moodle is one technology that we will use and explore, and wikis is one more technology, and these are going to go hand in hand. All instructions will be provided. So as RC coordinators, it's mostly whatever instructions and guidelines we provide on Moodle, you have to act on them. We will create the wiki, we will help create the logins and all. None of it is very technology intensive, but you have to make sure that each of this happens in your own RC. So overall, the workshop is highly participatory, highly collaborative, in both the remote classroom, remote center modes as well as the online modes. There will be lots of assignments, including watch this video and answer these questions, create a material for your course and so on. And we are using all that to build, to create common resources for engineering educators, which we later post on the wiki itself and anybody can use them. So it's like a crowdsourcing effort to create good quality instructional materials for use of ICT in engineering colleges. So now to some of the specific content. This is just for information. We'll provide a lot more about this. So we'll start with developing learning objectives in the course. And right after objectives, and a very important topic that will be discussed is how to write effective assessment questions. What are the different levels of assessment questions? How can we help students think at higher cognitive levels? So the first two modules are the foundations and fundamentals. And even if we've been doing all this as teachers, there's formal theory to be learned here, especially in the higher order cognitive skills. Then we'll pick one specific technology, visualizations such as animations and simulations and videos, which are very common and very useful for engineering. And we'll explore a lot on how to find good visualizations, how to teach with visualizations, how to integrate them in our classes and so on. You may not be doing any programming of the animations and simulations itself, but you will be doing a lot of activities on how to integrate good visualizations into your own teaching. Then we look at one very effective set of techniques called active learning, which can be used for all the technologies. And we look at some specific active learning techniques like peer instruction and think, pair, share and so on. And towards the end of the workshop, we'll come to a very new model. This has been popular only in the last couple of years using technology. It's called flipped classroom. So what actually happens in a flipped classroom is, until now, whatever was done inside of class is being done outside, and what students do outside class now is being done inside. So what do I mean by this? If I asked you, what do students do, what happens inside a classroom? Most of you would say that the teacher teaches and there is some lecturing, some information transmission, some content delivery that happens inside the classes, inside the classroom. And outside the classroom, students do homework and assignments and they assimilate the content. A flipped classroom is reversed using technologies and using videos. So how this happens, why you should do it, what activities you should create, we have a few sessions on this. And as I mentioned earlier, student collaboration and promoting collaborative work is something we want to focus on, because the moment our students graduate and go to the workplace, all projects in the workplace are collaborative. So students really need to learn not just how to work with somebody else, but how to collaborate on specific projects. So as teachers, we have to help students do this well, and we have to facilitate effective collaboration. So we're going to do some sessions on how we can facilitate student collaboration, what kind of project should we give, and how ICT tools are useful in this. And then we'll also, throughout this, we'll keep looking at some new educational technology tools that will help us achieve all these objectives. This comes to a very important question, that as a coordinator, what exactly is your role? And if you look at, if you think about the domain-based workshops, there your role may be slightly different, because you may have been the experts in those domains and many of you may have several years of experience and so on. But in this topic of pedagogy and integration of ICT, there you may be as new to the area as the participants. So what exactly is your role? So let's look at some specific points related to your role. Your main role throughout this workshop in January is to facilitate the activities in the sessions, both the synchronous and the online component. So here let's just jump into an example. And we will have many active learning techniques in the workshop itself. So the workshop is not going to be a lecture. At most, the instructor here from IIT Bombay will speak for about 15 minutes, like I've been doing so far, And immediately there will be an activity for every participant in every RC to do a specific task. So let's look at an example. And right now I want each one of you to play the role of a participant in your own RC. So I'm going to pose a question. All activity slides are going to look blue here. So here is a multiple choice question. So what I want you all to do is to read this question, and right now just pretend you are the participant. You can choose the best option for this question, and you can convey your answer through chat, and then I'll tell you what happens. So the question for you right now, so that this is activity time. If you see a blue slide, it means everybody has to start doing something. You have to decide that a teacher should use technology in the classroom because there are three reasons. Because technology is cool, everybody is using it, teachers are using it, students are using it, so a teacher should also use it. Or is the best option for technology use that technology can improve interest of students in the class? For example, the teacher can show interesting videos. Or is it that technology has capabilities to improve learning? For example, animations can make invisible items visible. So according to you, which of these is the best reason, best option for using technology? So think about what your answer is and convey it through the chat window. Okay, so looks like a lot of you have answered. And what happens in this, in such an activity, is that usually we wait for about 2 minutes, just like now, for everybody to answer. And then from here, we will tell you what the majority answers were. So it turns out that for this question, a lot of you have said that choice 3, technology has capabilities to improve learning, such as animations can make invisible visible. So most of you have thought that choice 3 is actually the best option. And again, see, there are some questions where there is no single right or wrong answer, but we can say one is better than the other. Many of you, actually some of you have said that all three are important, and a few of you have said that choice 2 is the most important. So we can actually, what we do in the actual workshop following such a question, if you can stop sending your responses, I think I got all your responses. Majority is 3, and some of you have said all of them, 1, 2, 3, and a few of you have said 2. So it turns out actually technology can do all of it, and in the workshop we will see how all are possible. But perhaps the reason for using is more for one reason, or why we should use it is the emphasis is more for one reason and less for the other. For example, okay, everybody is using technology. That is a fact that we have to be aware of, and we will see how to use that fact. But that should not be the basis of designing our lessons. It's something we should be aware of, but we should design our lessons using technology more so because technology is directly connected to students' motivation as well as learning. However, if the use of reason for using technology stopped at the interest, then our life would be a little easier. We could just demo videos. But what we have to really keep in mind is how to use technology to improve learning. So as teachers, what reason 3 is what we really have to keep in mind in a very strong manner. Reasons 2 and 1 also may be important. We are not saying they're wrong. They are, but they may not be as important as reason 3. So now the question, what we would do in an actual workshop, in the actual workshop, is after this question, we would look at how technology can be used to improve learning, then how it can be used to generate interest, and so on. Okay, so this was just a demonstration example for you, but the way the instructions will come in the actual workshop is a slide like this will come with a bubble which says, participant, please vote your choice. So your participant will either vote like that, or they'll use flashcards, they'll do something. And what you have to do as coordinators is convey the majority answer either through AVU chat, or we'll see if we can get the clicker part going, okay, the polling part going. So we'll use some technology through AVU, and as RC coordinators, you have to convey the majority answer to us, because what you are the bridge between the IIT Bombay instructors and the 5,000 participants that are there. And there will be very clear instructions on each slide. The moment you see a blue slide, you know that something has to be done. Here is another example of an activity. I don't want you to do the activity. I'll just show you what it looks like. This is an activity called Think, Pair, Share, which we'll use immediately following the previous peer instruction. So there'll be some things for each of the phases, and participants will have to do these three things. And what we are asking coordinators is to convey the two reasons from your center, not your own reasons, but the two reasons that come from your participants. So as you see that whenever there is a blue slide like this or like this, there will be task for you, and what you will be doing is facilitating these activities. That's exactly, so the last two examples were how you facilitate these activities in the sessions. As I mentioned earlier, there will be clear guidelines on each slide, and so I don't want you to answer the question right now, we'll do it in the main workshop, that was mostly as an example. There'll be clear guidelines on each slide, and in addition, you can also communicate queries between your participants. So let's say your participants have some query, they're not following something, feel free to use chat or Moodle, because we are logged into AVU chat and Moodle in real time. So you can use all these modes of communication to facilitate questions and responses between the participants and our IIT Bombay team. So mainly your role is what's on the slide. There's one more slide coming up, but this is your main role as coordinator. What we will do is post all the guidelines and the session slides and all on Moodle. Okay, one more thing that you need to do in your role as a coordinator is recall the wiki part that I mentioned a while ago. So you will have to coordinate the activities in this community wiki. So wiki is again a web page which everybody in the community, and here the community are the participant, faculty members, the coordinators and the instructors at IIT Bombay, the TAs at IIT Bombay. So this wiki will be coordinated and authored by all people. So as RC coordinators, you have to register yourself in the wiki by sending email to this address. Each wiki will be linked from a specific email ID. So please send email to this particular address from the email ID that you want to be linked with the wiki. And this needs to be done by December 10th. We'll post these slides and the instructions. We'll also send out another email. But if you do it by December 10th, then we will send an invite to you on a wiki invite. You have to accept the invite and you have to go through the projects, and then there'll be instructions within the invite and the wiki on what to do further. And then you'll have to regularly check the wiki. So all these instructions on what to do will be given. So right now your first task is to send an email to this email address. If you want, you can take a moment and write this down. We will also send another email. The address is resinetworkshop.iitb@gmail.com. And please send it from the email ID that you want to be linked with the wiki. In that email that you send us, mention your name and your RC name. That's all you need to send us. You don't need to send us any other information right now. And as we mentioned earlier, the purpose of the wiki is to get a community. It's like a platform where everybody can upload resources and everybody can use them. What has happened in the prior workshops is that a lot of good material has been created, but that's all sitting in Moodle. It's hidden within Moodle, and getting it out of Moodle to get all the faculty members to use it has been difficult, especially since we have 2 and 3,000 faculty participants. So if it's in the wiki, it's all there, and everybody can use it and access it easily. So that's why we want to get this community effort going. So just reiterating, your main roles as faculty coordinators to facilitate activities, communicate with us, facilitate and coordinate the wiki, and ask us questions whenever you have it. So what we'll do right now is throw the floor open to questions. We can do a floor transfer with video as well as chat. So okay, hello, this is Mukesh Patel, School of Technology.
Now my query is, I'm not clear with the wiki activity that you just mentioned. And the other thing is, as you mentioned, motivate the college faculty to participate in the wiki activity. Does it mean, I mean, do you mean the participants to be involved in the activity or all the faculty members?
Okay, so let me just repeat the question and then I'll respond. The question was, the wiki activity isn't clear who should be involved in it, and the people who will be involved in the activity are the participants of the workshop. So when we say college faculty, in the long term it can be all faculty, but in the near and medium term, especially in January, it's the participants who are going to be part of the workshop. So what you really have to do at this point is help us set up a specific wiki for your institute. So if you send us email on this address, we will give you instructions on how to set it up, and pretty much that's it at this point. Once you get started on it, then we'll say what exactly to do after it. The big goal is to help, or the big collective goal is to get materials throughout the workshop posted on the wiki. And how to do it, we'll continuously keep giving guidelines on it. So right now, send us email here, and the participants who are going to be part of the workshop, motivate them to use the wiki during the workshop, and very long term, you can also motivate your college faculty.
Hello madam, I am Revithi from Mukkurnak Engineering College. For this wiki, can the faculty members who are non-participants, can they contribute? They are having some materials.
So in the first round, since this is the first time we are trying it at such large scale, I would suggest that in the first round, we limit it to the participants who are part of the workshop in January. Let's begin by that part, because we have to give IDs to every person who wants to contribute and so on. So in the first round, we will limit it to the participants. We'll give ID to the wiki permissions only to participants who are part of the workshop. But once we get it going, once it's created, then we can consider opening it up to others. So right now, it's limited only to workshop participants.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you.
Oriental College of Technology, please go ahead.
I want to ask you only one question. Which Moodle will be utilized in this workshop, like our local Moodle or IIT Bombay Moodle?
So it's
yes, ma'am?
The it.iitb.ac.in Moodle. So it's Moodle from IITB.
Okay.
Hello, good afternoon, ma'am.
Hello, good afternoon.
Perimony so 5, 6, 7 our faculties are running the program, and 8th to 18th. So they are whether they can possible to submit the assignment in your Moodle, or whether they can complete and they can keep it themselves itself.
So 8th to 18th,
when they can submit the
all
assignment,
the activities
ma'am?
Will be online. So we will post deadlines when to do it and all that. But essentially, 8th to 18th, they will be in their own colleges. So between 8th and 18th, all the workshop will be only in online mode. It's not even that we'll be transmitting. There'll be homeworks and videos. They can do it whenever they have time between 8th and 18th. What are the deadlines? That will be staggered. So some assignments will have a deadline of January 15th, and some might have it January 20th, and so on. So January 5th, 6th, 7th, as well as 19, 20, 21, they will be physically present in the classroom. 8th to 18th, they don't need to assemble
for
anywhere.
The
please go ahead.
Okay. For the faculty registration,
uh-huh.
So we have to use the wiki only. It's correct, ma'am?
There'll be both. So, for the registration, so let me answer this globally. In terms of technology, we are using two technologies. One, the Moodle technology is going to be there as it is. There's going to be no change in the Moodle. We are adding one additional technology component, which is the wiki. Okay? So the wiki is like you are learning now how to use wiki for your own classes. But for the registration and for assignments and all, we'll still be using Moodle. Okay, so keep Moodle as your primary technology.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
All communication is through Moodle. And if there's any additional thing we need to do, we'll communicate through Moodle. Okay.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Sure. D.Y. Patil.
Good noon.
Hello.
Good noon, ma'am.
Hello.
Nice to see this pedagogy going on, because I am always a part and I am associated with IIT with Aditi. If you could recollect me, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
The question which I want to pose right now is, since it is effective use of ICT in engineering education, will diploma holder teachers, faculty at diploma institutes will be eligible for this workshop? And along with that, something extended, can MBA faculty be included for this workshop?
MBA faculty are not eligible for this workshop, because all our examples are going to be from engineering and computer science. So MBA definitely not eligible, but diploma college people are eligible to attend. Knowledge Institute of Technology, please go ahead.
We also have the same question, ma'am. Whether we can have this polytechnic faculty, MBA, arts and science.
Okay, so long as the faculty members are teaching topics and subjects in engineering or science, it's fine. But if it's MBA, management, finance, arts, they're not eligible. The main reason is that we are going to be focusing mostly on engineering, but that's the main reason.
Can our technical assistant attend this workshop, because they are taking the practicals of the students who are in the SCT or B class? So these are the eligible to attend the workshop?
So we can't give them funding. We can't pay the technical assistants if they and no certificates can be given to them.
They will got the participation certificate.
No, they won't get participation certificates. It's only faculty members who can get participation certificates. Yeah, IES College, Bhopal.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Ma'am, I would like to know about there is having difference between Wiki and flipped classroom technology.
Yeah, we'll discuss that in detail in the workshop.
And flipped classroom technology, which we are using in our flipped classroom.
Yeah.
And what is the difference between the Wiki and flipped?
What is the difference? Okay, so I'll first tell you what is a Wiki, because that's something you need to know right now. Wiki is like a web page which people can edit collaboratively. And the reason why I'm explaining this is because you'll all get an invite to come and collaborate on this Wiki. It's like a collaborative document writing. Flipped classroom will have many sessions during the workshop itself. Okay, so even on Wiki, we'll have many sessions during the workshop itself. So right now, what is important to begin with is just send us email so that we can get you started on the Wiki. Okay, flipped classroom, essentially what happens there is that videos are shown outside of class and activities are done inside of class. But how to do that, how to choose the videos, what exactly to do, we'll have many sessions in the workshop. Anurag Group, please go ahead.
To start with, we need to first register in the Wiki, and we need to make our faculty to register in the Wiki. And those who registered in Wiki are only eligible who registered for the main workshop.
Okay. So let me answer this to everybody. The primary mode of communication is still Moodle. So whatever you've been doing so far, registration, guidelines, instructions, everything is happening through Moodle. The IT.IITB Moodle.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So that is our logistics mode of mode for the workshop. That's actually how we are going to communicate with you. Why we introduce the Wiki now is that is more for an academic reason, because we want to have a platform where all the activities that have been created can be made accessible to everybody else in a community fashion. So use Moodle for registration, use Moodle for reading instructions, for posting queries and so on. And think of Wiki as an additional homework as part of the workshop. So Wiki is just one of the technologies you'll be using as part of the workshop. Moodle is still your primary mode of communication.
Okay. Of course, madam.
Yeah.
But you said the more number of faculty to get registered in Wiki.
Yes, so that's...
Is it a primary requirement that those who...
We encourage it. It's not a requirement.
Are only eligible for...
No, that's not true. That's not the case. So everybody, anybody
so
else...
Even without Wiki also, they can go for the...
That's right. That's correct.
Main workshop at JAM.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Om Institute.
Hello.
Om Institute, please go ahead. Yeah.
Yeah.
Ma'am, when will I get my course schedule on the Moodle? I have already connected to the Moodle. When will I get the course schedule of this workshop?
A week before the workshop. So around the first week of January. The dates have been fixed and they are as I mentioned in the presentation earlier. This presentation will be made available to all of you.
Next question is whether the Akash tablets will be used in the main workshop?
No, we are not going to use the Akash tablets in the main workshop. Selvam College of Technology, please go ahead.
Ma'am, whether MCA department faculty can attend the program?
So long as they are teaching any computer subjects, yeah.
MCA department faculty can attend the program?
Yeah, they can. They can attend, but what you need to tell them is that the focus will be mostly on computer subjects and engineering subjects. Yeah. Sorry, what was your next question? Okay.
Ma'am, the participants want to be in remote center on 5, 6, 7 and 19, 20, 21.
That's correct. Yeah, that 5, 6, 7, then 19, 20, 21. That's correct. Bansal Institute, please go ahead.
Good afternoon, ma'am. My question is related to Wiki registration.
Okay.
Whether the coordinator has to do the registration or coordinator or the member itself will do the registration.
Okay. We will handle the process. And once you send us an email, as I mentioned earlier, and we'll send you the guidelines, but we will handle most of the process from our end. Each participant does have to do something, okay. But we will handle the process.
Okay. And whether any pre-work has to be done by the participants before the workshop?
What we will do is around December 20th, we'll send an email getting people started with the workshop. So there we may have some small assignment, but around December 20th, we'll let you know about it.
So because the course content consists of some, we have to design the learning objectives.
Right. So if there is any pre-workshop assignment, we'll let you know well ahead of time, around the 20th or so. For example, there may be one survey that all participants may have to write. May have to respond to and all, but around the 20th or so, we'll get in touch with you about that. Jawaharlal Nehru National College, please go ahead.
Madam, is there any limitations to add the members to the wiki?
No, they have to be participants of this workshop. That's all.
Okay.
Everybody
so
who registers.
The RC coordinator has to register and he or she has to add the wiki.
The RC coordinator has to accept the invite and then what happens later, we'll let you know, we'll just ask you to send a list of the participants. So, the main thing is that it's restricted to the participants of the workshop. Agni College.
Go ahead. Good afternoon, ma'am. During the main workshop, any lab sessions will be there?
Okay. We may have some lab sessions and what we mean by lab sessions is that the participants will have to log in to some website and work on some activity online, but we won't have any hardware based labs. So it's mostly, there'll be some sessions where they'll have to work on a PC during the workshop. So you, go ahead.
Whether PG students are permitted to attend this workshop? PG in engineering.
Okay, they can attend in terms of they can sit in the classroom, but we can't fund them in any way. We can't make any sort of payment to them. And no certificates will be given.
That's okay, ma'am.
No certificates can be given at all, unfortunately. Yeah.
Okay. And when exactly, madam, the registration process will be started?
Yeah, just first week of December. Yeah. Go ahead, please.
Madam, you have asked that to maintain a regular check over the wiki pages once we go registered on the wiki. And you have asked that to make sure that we are not uploading the files. And you have mentioned Google Docs as one of the ICT tools we can use to upload files. I would like to know, ma'am, what are other ICT tools we can use for uploading files?
Okay, so see, the thing is, what we will do in the workshop, one of the goals is to expose participants and make all faculty members familiar with the various technologies that exist. Later, for your own classes and your own courses, which ones you want to use and which ones you like, that's your choice. So the way we'll be getting you to get familiar with these technologies is by having you use it yourself. So there is Moodle, there's Google Docs, there's Wiki, and there's many others. We'll pick a few of these, and during different parts of the workshop, we'll say work with it for some time. So all I can say at this point is Moodle is something you're already familiar with, and we want to get you started on the Wiki process so that you also see how it behaves, and then you can make a decision whether you want to use it in your class or not. KMEA Engineering College.
This Wiki is same as Wikipedia only, right, ma'am?
No, Wikipedia uses the technology of wikis in the back end. So Wiki is actually a technology which can be used for educational purposes. Wikipedia is for information. Wikipedia is essentially an encyclopedia. It's a global encyclopedia about various topics. So there is a difference between the two. But one is a technology tool which the other uses.
Okay, the second question is,
yeah.
From our institution, for each participant, they need a individual permission letter, or for the entire institution, their name can be written in a single permission letter?
The remote center coordinator should send us a combined list of all the participants, and these names should also reflect upon the permission letter. You can send us one single permission letter, it's absolutely fine. But any participant who is added to the list after you submit the permission letter, then you have to give us a separate permission letter for any new additional members.
Okay.
Yeah, and while registering, even if it is a combined letter, every participant has to register it individually, has to upload it individually.
Yeah, while uploading, they can use this permission letter, right?
Yeah, you can have a single permission letter, but every participant has to upload it individually.
Only computer science and engineering faculty are eligible.
Yeah. So.
Yes.
Siddhaganga College, the answer to that is that we prefer computer science and engineering domains because most examples are from these particular domains. But participation from science domains are also accepted. So ideally, we would not want any management.
Oh, then mechanical, civil.
Yeah, all mechanical, civil. Engineering will cover mechanical, okay. Civil, aerospace, chemical.
Okay.
All these kind of disciplines.
No, no. Most of the examples you are considering from computer science and engineering program.
Yes.
But how can they attend, that is, the handle mechanical, civil?
So engineering will cover engineering.
Are they eligible?
So engineering will cover all the major branches.
Yeah, that is true. Engineering covers all the programs.
So some of the examples that we'll be dealing with will be common to most of these branches. Yeah, Sri Narayana Gurukulam College.
Yeah, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I just want clarification. The participants have to register through Wiki. And as well as they have to send the permission letter separately.
First thing is they have to register online. That's the most important and the first thing that they have to do. Then they will be directed to the Moodle. And from the Moodle, later on, we will send. You will have to send us a list of the participants. And then we will give you the link for the Wiki. That is the third step. The first is registering online.
Shanmuga College.
Good evening, ma'am.
Yeah, good evening.
Yeah, good evening. My question is, so you will be giving giving us some, there are many teaching tools. So these teaching tools and all, we need to install period to the workshop. So whether you will be giving us the resources period to the workshop so that we can install and we can try it before the workshop.
So there won't be any major installation per se. So maximum we will try to make sure that there are standalone system wherein online recording etc. are possible. So as far as possible, we'll try to make sure that we'll make sure that there are no separate installations required.
Okay, thanks. And one more question is, initially, as I understood that, there will be teaching tools. And one more thing is, the course plan, whether you will be covering this course plan also, how staff going to make a course plan for their subject. and where they have to use the teaching tool properly, this and all we'll be covering the session, because I have to tell this to the participant, my participant, they will ask me question how it is useful for us.
So yes, in to an extent, yes, we will be looking at course planning, but we'll be taking an instance of course planning, that is lesson plan. So the focus will be on lesson plan, but yes, you build on to create a course plan. Yeah, concept mapping, etc. Okay, are relevant to course planning. So all these will be covered.
Whether the first year engineering faculties of maths, physics, chemistry and English departments are eligible to participate?
Maths, physics and chemistry is fine. English, no.
Okay, thank you.
No English and no management also.
Yeah. I want to make a broadcast to everybody. One of the main goals of the workshop is to help every participant create materials for their own course. So if any of the participants ask you as coordinators, what's the use of this workshop and why should I sit in it, you can say that for the course that they're teaching this particular semester, the next semester, we will help them create learning materials and activities and lesson plans and course plans and all. So we have sessions and the examples we take will be from the courses that the participants will be teaching. And when we ask participants to do their homework, it will be in the context of their own courses. So that's one of the major goals of the workshop. School of Management Hello. Sciences, please go ahead.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Go ahead.
Ma'am, please. I want to ask a very short question. What is the procedure of to registration in Wiki? Who sent his email ID, WhatsApp coordinator or remote center coordinator?
There is no separate workshop coordinator for this workshop. The remote center okay, coordinator you, has to take all the responsibility and he has to follow up. There is no separate workshop coordinator for this workshop.
Yeah, we have only, there is only a single coordinator from every RC in this workshop.
It, okay, could, so it could be the remote center coordinator himself, and as in some cases another faculty member has been deputed only because the remote center coordinator is busy.
National Institute of Science and Technology, please go ahead.
Well, ma'am, I just want to ask one question. What will be the timing of the workshop each day?
Each day, okay, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m., 1 hour break for lunch. We'll have a
thank you very much, ma'am.
Yeah, we will have a question and answer sessions every day through AVU. That includes it. BMS College, please go ahead.
I have one question regarding the course content. I understand that we'll be developing the learning objectives and the course content. As the workshop coordinator, should I deal with any of the copyright issues which the participants might ask in the process?
Can you elaborate a little bit more? I mean, copyright issues of them using each other's work, or can you just elaborate your question a little bit more, please?
Exactly. See, we'll be preparing the content for the course, what we are going to teach in the subsequent semesters.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And maybe some of us are with autonomous institutes and some of them are affiliated to a specific university as such. So when we prepare the course content, will the part and maybe more detailing on the course, will some issues of copyright pop up was the thought that okay. I had. Will they ask me?
Okay, so I have two parts in my answer and then I'll ask my colleague Dr. Mukta also. So firstly, all contents of the course from our end will be put up in open source. Yes. That's the mandate of this whole program. Okay, so all our slides, our videos, our examples, they're put up in open source. Now, regarding the assignments that we get, so far what has been happening is people submit assignments for their own course, and this is not the entire course planning. So most assignments are a sample. It's like write one activity for one module or do this topic, because that's all we can cover in the workshop. If there is a problem with the copyright even for that one thing, maybe we can discuss it later. But I think that given that they'll be doing sample assignments and not their entire course, I don't think copyright should be a problem.
Fine.
Yeah.
And moreover, they're going to sign your common license.
Exactly. That's right. That's
saying
right.
That.
That's right.
Fantastic. So, thank you.
Roland.
Good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon.
Is there any lab session,
yes,
madam?
There will be sessions. There will be lab sessions in which participants will work on PCs, working on designing some activities and going to web pages. There are no hardware based labs, but there are PC based labs. Yes.
One more question, madam. Is the like registration will start after 23rd December or when, or 10th December onwards?
Registration will start on 1st December.
First December. So before that, madam, is there any like brochure will come to us?
Yes.
So that we will send them.
We will send you the brochure by the end of this week.
1120 Saint Aloysius. Go ahead.
Can we involve the faculty from the physics, chemistry, and mathematics?
Yes.
Because physics, this is an engineering student, engineering faculty book. So.
Physics, chemistry, and mathematics are okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Physics, chemistry, and mathematics who are teaching PG courses are fine.
Okay. Not at the graduate level. UG courses in the engineering background.
UG courses in an engineering college is also.
In engineering, there's a mathematics paper.
For engineering college,
in engineering there's a mathematics paper, chemistry, and all these things.
That's fine. For first year engineering, that's okay. Yeah.
Perumal College.
Hello.
Go ahead.
Good afternoon, ma'am. I have two questions. First one is whether external participants can be registered for this workshop.
External participants.
Yes. This is for all external participants and some of your own some of your own faculty.
Thank you, ma'am. My second question is that when we can start the registration, on which date?
We are starting registration on 1st of December, and before that you will get a soft copy of the brochure which can be circulated in the neighboring colleges.
Carmel Engineering College.
My question is how this course will enable all other faculty in the colleges so that they can make use of this new pedagogy as their strategy.
Okay, so
in other words, in simple words, how we can spread this new pedagogical strategy among our colleagues. Okay.
I think what you should do is start by using it in your own courses. So the participants who come for the workshop, use something in your own class and see how successful or not it is. Because one of the pieces of the workshop is also we will go over guidelines on how to evaluate if it is successful or not. And then you can hold a workshop for your own, you can hold your own workshop, or you can tell your colleagues what worked in your class and so on. So I would say start by using some of these in your own workshop and spread the success stories. Let's start there. Afterwards, we'll talk about other things like having community groups and so on.
Thank you, ma'am. Another question, how this new pedagogical strategy would be participatory when we employ it in our own classroom?
Yeah, they'll be very participatory. So we will go over specific pedagogical strategies where students interact with each other during the class. So many of
can you explain it by giving an
two examples we did in the presentation earlier. I call it peer instruction, where there was a question posed, people vote. Right now you were only one person in your institute, so you did not talk to anybody. But in the actual classroom, what happens is that students would discuss with each other before voting. And we'll go over a lot of these in the actual workshop. Yeah, please go ahead, Netaji.
Hello, good afternoon, ma'am. Sir, we have basic science department and BCA, MCA, MBA. So these faculties can participate.
MBA department cannot participate in this workshop.
But
they will not. And also the teachers, if they are teaching
basic sciences,
if they are teaching in the engineering college, only then.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
For BCA, if you have teachers who also teach MCA, only those teachers will be allowed.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so we are really concentrating on teachers teaching PG courses and teaching basic science courses in engineering colleges.
Is there any smart tool like smart board is required?
No.
During the content development?
No. You don't need to install any smart board. No, nothing. So whatever tools are required, we will, most of them will be through the internet. So you don't need a smart board or any such thing.
Wales University.
Can you use Akash tablet for wiki registration?
No, you don't need Akash tablets. We are not going to be using Akash tablets.
And second question, during the lab activity, you have only a group activity or individual activity?
There will be both group and individual activities. St. Xavier's Catholic College.
Yeah. Madam, will you teach anything on how to create animations?
Okay, so we won't be
in the classrooms.
Let me answer in two parts. The first answer is no, because we won't be teaching anything on the programming of animations. But what we will do is how to use animations to create strategies for the classroom. But if you want to know, should we, will we be doing Flash or will we be doing programming and development of animations? No, we won't. Not in this workshop.
Another, thank you. Another question I thought is in the logistics side, you have completely removed the honorarium for system administrator, but he will be part of our team throughout this workshop.
There is no need for a system administrator at all. You only need the remote center coordinator, some support staff, and the AVU coordinator. You do not need a system administrator or any TAs.
Amrita, please go ahead.
Yeah, I have a question regarding the registration procedure. Okay. The being a coordinator, I have already registered on Moodle. So, to register the remaining faculty, is it that I have to only give a list of the participants, or do they have to do some other procedure in order to get registered?
For the wiki, you as the remote center coordinator will have to send us a list of participants and we will take it up from there.
Okay, fine. Second, I have two more questions. What is the maximum number of participants in any institution? Like
that depends. That depends upon your seating capacity and the number of computers you can offer to your participants. You will be very shortly sent a link where you will have to fill up the capacity that you have in your institute.
Okay.
By capacity, I mean participants should be able to sit comfortably and do their work without, disturbing others and things like that.
Absolutely. One final question that I have is, I guess you told that it is meant only for faculty teaching PG courses. So are they alone, will they alone be getting certificates, or can we entertain faculty who are teaching UG courses also in engineering?
This is for faculty of all UG engineering courses, as well as teachers teaching PG courses in basic sciences.
So if it's
I misinterpreted. Yes. Yeah, sorry, I got it.
So MCA UG is and PG courses, MCA is okay. MSc is okay.
Okay.
Diploma teachers teaching in polytechnic colleges are also okay.
And
but no MBA.
Obviously.
Sorry.
No MBA, no English literature.
No, that's correct.
English literature.
No English literature.
Thank
please.
You.
Sri Datta Institute.
Hello. Madam, you told about this wiki, na?
Yeah.
So in this remote center coordinator has to send the mail to this email ID.
That's right.
And what about the participants? That whether the participants, they will also have to register separately or
so
what is it?
Let's start by the remote center coordinator sending email to that ID and. All guidelines will start from there.
Okay, thank you, madam.
But the participants have to register on the eOutreach website first. Yeah. Only after that will you get the list of participants at your college.
Tyagaraj College.
Madam, whether this workshop will cover the pedagogical aspect for only theory courses, or will it cover the other curricular components like the practical and project component also?
Yeah, so we will actually we do have some components about the projects, but the focus will be on the classroom-based theory courses. The focus will be more on that. Lab courses are not entirely ruled out, so if you have a teacher teaching lab courses, many of the techniques might be useful in the lab also, but we won't explicitly look at lab courses. So we won't look at how to do design and all. So primarily theory courses. Techno India Salt.
Hello.
Go ahead, please.
The theory session and lab session will be in the same classroom, or we will have a lab session in the different time?
So that's really up to you. What we need for the lab sessions are participants having access to computers. If it's all in the same room, computers and internet. See, the other option is if you ask participants to bring laptops, you can do everything in the classroom itself, provided you have internet.
Okay, in that case, you need internet as well?
Yes, internet is required.
Okay, and one more question, that why we need wiki? This time the lecture note and everything will be available in wiki, or it will be available in Moodle?
So Moodle is your primary mode of communication, okay? Communication, uploading, everything, okay. Primarily Moodle. So stick to Moodle. Think of wiki as an additional technology to explore for the course. So wiki is going to be more like the course content. No, it's not about the course logistics on wiki.
Knowledge Institute.
Good afternoon, madam.
Yes, go ahead.
Actually, this is regarding the laboratory. During SRC, we need the laboratory facility, which means the systems.
See, for some assignments, for some during workshop assignments, what the participants will need to do is work on PCs or laptops. So that is the extent to which you need systems. So we need participants to go to the internet and do some activity with the internet. That's all, that's the extent of the hands-on part. Now, whether they do it with a laptop in the classroom with wireless internet, or whether they go to a separate computer lab.
Madam, and then is this something related like that Wipro Mission 10X? We have that Mission 10X Learning Center in our college.
Okay.
Is this pedagogy related to that?
So they also may be conducting similar workshops, but ours is a MHRD government initiative, and perhaps on some common topics they also may be conducting, but we are not affiliated with them per se.
Madam, my question is, since we are planning to make the learning objectives as the first objective of our workshop, do you want the faculty to select a particular course beforehand and then come to the thing, so that they can have their material ready with them? They can make assessment questions and everything ready?
Yeah, okay. So they can do it. What we usually do is to ask them to choose the course that they're teaching in that particular semester. So things are very fresh in their mind. We don't mandate that they bring in materials, but if they do want to bring it, sure, why not? Gandhi Engineering College.
What is the minimum number of participants to be registered in this WhatsApp?
The minimum number of participants in your institute has to be 30.
Is this WhatsApp applicable for all the streams? ESC, IT, electronic, all the departments?
All engineering disciplines, MCA and MSc. No. Diploma teachers also, but absolutely no MBA, no arts, no humanities, no economics.
Is there any laboratory associated with this WhatsApp?
You will need only systems with internet for the participants to do their in-class assignments.
There is no hardware-based system.
No hardware-based systems.
Again, since this question is coming up many times, let me do a broadcast so that we don't keep getting the same question over and over. What will happen in the workshop are sessions from which are broadcast from here, activities that participants will do, and they will use computers or laptops, PCs or laptops, to access the internet to do activities. No hardware and no additional software need to be installed.
Nanamani College.
Can you please tell me the RC coordinator roles and responsibility once again?
RC coordinator's main role is to facilitate the sessions as we went through in the presentation. And we'll give guidelines at every stage, and some examples are present in the presentation which will be made available to you.
And then can you please tell me the number of participants able to take place in this workshop? How many can participate?
Your minimum number is 30, and the upper limit is as many as you can accommodate in your classroom. you remember, just remember that you have to give them PCs or laptops also. So please keep that in mind when you are giving us your capacity number.
Government Engineering College, Bikaner.
I want to ask just a single question. Is there the same TAD norms for external participant? Because actually the workshop is break up in two parts, such as 5 to 6 Jan and 19 to 21st Jan.
We will give the TA into two, because there are two sessions, but only for those participants who are traveling from further than 100 kilometers.
Ratnavel.
Whether the coordinator has to participate in the offline activities?
You're most welcome to do so. But okay, no participation certificate. You'll get a coordinator certificate.
Okay.
Yeah. I would encourage you to do it anyway.
Kurukshetra University.
My question is regarding the number of minimum number of participants in the workshop. Because actually we have average number of 15 or 20 participants are there. We have conducted 7 workshops so far. So we have average of 15 to 20 participants only.
We will discuss this particular problem on 29th when your remote center coordinator comes here.
Mohandas College.
Good evening, ma'am. I had a question. Whether the Faculty of Science of Biotechnology Department can attend this workshop? Biotechnology Engineering Department we have, and the faculty is from MSc.
Yeah, if they're teaching at the MSc level, that's fine.
And my next question is whether we have to install any open source tools earlier before the conduct of the workshop. For the course planning, you have mentioned some open source tools.
Nothing before the workshop. Whatever is needed, we'll send guidelines over email, over Moodle. Nothing before the workshop.
Rajkumar Goel.
Ma'am, my first question was the same. If the number of participant is less than 30, so I got the answer. So it's not need to give you the answer. And the second is, up to what date we have to send the mail for WikiLink?
By December 10th.
BMS?
Yes. This is the same question which many of our colleagues have asked you. You are going to decide on 29th, am I right, regarding the number of participants? And a message will be conveyed to us, because as a remote center coordinator, I will not be able to be present in Bombay because of my practical exams here.
We will be considering the problem of low attendance, where the institutes where there is normal more than 30 people attending the workshop, there is no problem. The problem only happens when there are less than 30, less than 20 or 15. We are keeping those remote centers aside, and we will be having discussions with them about how to solve that problem. So if your institute already has a good, strong attendance, then there's no problem. Yeah, and yes, also we will be circulating the minutes of that meeting immediately. By Monday you should have the minutes of that meeting, even if you're not attending.
Based on which you're going to make a decision whether we are allowed to be a part of this or not. Am I right?
Right.
Yes, KMA.
Hello, ma'am. Yeah, hello, ma'am. I just want to know whether this virtual labs is included in this particular course, because I have found it very useful for the students as well as for the teachers, right. These virtual labs. Yeah.
So we don't have a specific session on virtual labs, but we have a long multiple sessions on visualization such as animation simulations, and we'll include virtual labs as a part of that. So what we do is have participants go and find visualizations which are useful, so we can include virtual labs as examples. But thanks for the suggestion.
If you can just show that, I have personally found it's very useful.
Which subject have you used
students
it for?
As well as for teachers.
Yeah, which subject have you used it for?
I'm surveying.
Surveying. Civil engineering?
Yeah.
Okay.
Civil engineering,
fine.
Yeah.
We'll keep it in mind. Thanks for the suggestion.
And I want to ask whether tablet will be required, Akash tablet or not. And second question is that how many minimum participants will be required? Because from this January, our academic calendar will be started officially. So it may be case that we may not, we may get the less than 30 participants.
Yes, I have been saying this for the others also. We require a minimum of 30, and we have made a list of the centers which have been having low attendance, and we will be talking to them on 29th when the remote center coordinators come here for this interactive meet. And your first question, we do not need the Akash tablets for this workshop.
Silicon Institute.
My question is, being a coordinator, do I have to evaluate some of the assignments that have been provided to the given to participants for that?
As a coordinator, you won't have to do any evaluation.
Yes, Amrita.
It's regarding the 29th meeting. Should all the RC center RC coordinators should be there in Mumbai, or is just specifically sent out for
specific
people?
It is an invitation for all our remote centers. We are expecting all the remote center coordinators to attend this meeting. One of the issues that we will be discussing is the low attendance.
Right. And the second thing is there any requirement regarding the bandwidth of the internet that is required in the lab?
No, just normal. Nothing extra heavy, that's all.
Specific. Nothing extra specific or right?
No.
Sir, I want to ask regarding online component which will run from January 8th to 18th.
Okay.
What will be the probable activities and how coordination shall be done?
Yeah, so what happens there is, as RC coordinator, you have almost no role during the online component. After the participants come to physically attend your session in January 5th, 6th and 7th, they'll go back to their colleges, or during the day, they'll resume their activities. We will post some resources like videos and reading, which participants have to view. Whenever they have computer and internet access, they can do it from home also. And they have to do some assignments and submit it. So those will be all individual activities between 8th and 18th, which can be done at any time during that period.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
I'd just like to add, we expect the remote center coordinator to be monitoring the activities during this 8th to 18th, that particular interval. We expect that the remote center coordinator is monitoring all the activities. He doesn't have to specifically do anything with the participants, but definitely monitoring.
Yeah, Dr. Mahalingam, College.
Regarding the 29th workshop, so on behalf of my RCC coordinator, I will be participating in this workshop. So whether who has attended this 29th workshop, whether RCC or also workshop coordinator?
The RC coordinator has to attend the 29th workshop.
Okay.
We do not want a substitute for that workshop. We want the remote center coordinator to attend it, and if he or she cannot attend it, we will be circulating the minutes of the meeting anyway on the next working day.
Okay, no need for the reports.
Yes.
Hello.
Madam, say suppose if the number of participants is more, so is it possible to have more than one remote center coordinator?
No, only one remote center coordinator per center.
Okay, madam, thank you.
Okay, one last question. Nagole Institute.
Ma'am, can you give the in detail about the simulation? Can you explain the not theoretical concept as well as the anim concepts of the laboratory's point of view, simulation point of view? So this is basically we are seeking in terms of the electronics and communication engineering. So if you go for the VLSI, especially particularly, so we required the some animation like designing point of view,
OSINT
design point of view.
We will be doing one session on animations and videos that are useful for various topics. We will have one session on it.
Thank you.
Okay, so that brings us to the end of this workshop. What we will do at this point is make today's slides available to you, and all other communication will go through the usual channels. If there are any logistics questions, you can please ask them. Otherwise, that brings us to the end of this session.
Yeah, I have a small question, sir. This is with respect to the system administrator who is not being included as a part of this team. Since we need to take people to lab for certain activities, I would request you to include them to be a part of it. Otherwise, it will be very difficult with only AVU coordinator. This is just my submission.
There is really no need for a system administrator role in this workshop. The participants only have to access the internet. That is all. You do not really need a system administrator for that.
Hello, good evening, madam.
Yes.
Regarding this pedagogy workshop, only RC coordinator will be there. Apart from that, some assistance we can have, no, madam, to monitor all of that activities. Because technical assistance also, just like you are given for other workshops, generally we used to have technical sitting staff, teaching assistants, two or three staff members who are going to assist me to look after all the attendance and other things and other things.
We,
just like that, every
we
time
expect,
you had in various workshops.
Yeah.
Because a single person, because we'll be having academic activity, all other things will be going on simultaneously. Because not in a single day, in a year, academic institutions will be free of workload. That's why, because other workshops also you have given two or three teaching assistants are there.
There are no teaching assistants in this workshop. The remote center coordinator has just to take the attendance, and that too only for a period of 3 days once and 3 days afterwards. That is all. And the participants are, they need to just access the internet on the computers. So there is no need for a technical assistant, there is no need for a teaching assistant, no need for a system administrator. So that is why we have removed all these roles from this workshop.
Yes, NIT Manipur, go ahead.
Yeah, ma'am, I just want to ask something about Akash tablet. So the stock in IIT Bombay is over, or can we still become Akash tablet center?
I will discuss this with you when you come here on 29th. So we are ending this session, this coordinator's workshop for pedagogy. And if you all have any queries, please do send them to e-outreach, or any fund related queries to workshop funds at csc.iitb.ac.in, and we will get back to you if there are any other queries. Thank you very much. And we expect to see the remote center coordinators only here at IIT on 29th. Thank you very much.